So we are going to start the last talk, the invited talk of this algebra session today. It's a pleasure to introduce you Osamu Ishama. He's from Japan. He's a professor at Nagoya University. He finished his PhD 20 years ago in Kyoto University, and his advisor was Hiroaki Ihikata. His thesis was about some categories of lattices associated to a central idempotent. For his outstanding work in the representation theory of finite dimensional algebras, he won several prizes. In 2007, he got the first ICRA award, where ICRA means International Conferences on Representations of Algebras. Afterwards, he received three other prizes for young mathematicians by the Mathematical Society of Japan. He developed a higher dimensional Auslander writing theory, showing the existence of n almost split sequences. He also extended to higher dimensions the Auslander correspondence, which was just known for Morita equivalence classes of art in algebras, with both global dimension at most 2 and dominant dimension at least 2. And Osama extended this for general n. He has also been working on Calabi-Yau categories that are strongly connected with the cluster algebras of Fomin and Zelewinski. In a famous joint work with Shoshino, they used the concept of mutation in triangulated categories. And as an application, they obtain a complete classification of the rigid Cohen-Macaulay modulus over some special rings. And today, Osamu is going to talk about tilting Cohen-Macaulay representations.
Thank you very much. And it's my great pleasure to give a lecture here. So today, what I will discuss is a comparison of the category of Cohen-Macaulay modules with two quite different kinds of category. First one is the derived category, and the second one is cluster category. So my first half of talk is about the derived category, and I will discuss connection between derived category and Cohen-Macaulay modules, which are graded by certain abelian group. And throughout my talk, for simplicity, I always assume K is an algebraically closed field of characteristic zero. And to explain some easy motivating example, let me remind you a famous theorem of Gabriel about quiver representation. So it is about for an acyclic connected quiver Q, and we denote by KQ the path algebra of quiver Q. In this case, KQ is representation finite in the sense that there are only finitely many isomorphism classes of indecomposable KQ modules if and only if the quiver Q is a Dynkin quiver. This means that Q is obtained from these three kinds of ADE Dynkin diagram by replacing each edge by an arrow. And in this case, there is a bijection between isomorphism classes of indecomposable KQ modules and all positive roots in the corresponding root system. So this is a very old result by Gabriel, and it is basic in representation theory of quiver. Now, to understand the structure of a quiver representation, it is reasonable to consider derived category. I denote by mod KQ the category of finitely generated KQ module, and by DB mod KQ the bounded derived category of mod KQ. In this case, a classical, also classical result by Happel tells us that for a Dynkin quiver Q, the Auslander right-hand quiver of the derived category of KQ is given by a certain infinite quiver ZQ constructed from Q. I just show you some example of ZQ. If quiver, yes, so we choose type A3 quiver in this orientation, well, then the quiver ZA3 is this infinite quiver. And actually, if we draw the Auslander right-hand quiver of mod KQ, then we have such a triangle. So there are 6 positive roots in the root system of type 3, and all of them appear here. And each of them corresponds to certain indecomposable KQ module. And each arrow shows certain morphism between these representations of KQ. And yeah, these morphisms are called irreducible morphism, which generates the category in some sense. Now we can extend this Auslander right-hand quiver of module category to that for derived category by extending in this way. So original module category is this triangle, and here we have next triangle. This is module category shift by 1. And in this way, we take a copy of module category and shift of it. Okay. So now I will go to Cohen-Macaulay representation. And in this talk, I will restrict the consideration for Gorenstein ring. We call R a Gorenstein ring if it is a Noetherian ring first of all, and moreover, the injective dimension of R over itself is finite on left-hand side, also right-hand side. So I don't assume commutativity of R here. And for a Gorenstein ring R, we call R module X Cohen-Macaulay if there is no positive extension from X to R. So this vanishing condition of extension group is the definition of Cohen-Macaulay. And now, I denote by CMR the category of Cohen-Macaulay R modules. And to relate Cohen-Macaulay representation to derived category or cluster category I explain later, we need to modify this category slightly. Yeah. It is a so-called stable category due to Auslander-Bridger, and it is usually denoted as CM bar R. Yes, so this category has the same object as CMR. But the morphism group is slightly modified. Yes, actually we take quotient of original morphism group of in CMR by taking quotient by PXY. This is a subgroup consisting of all morphisms factoring through projective R modules. Yes, so this is stable category is have various nice properties, and I will explain a few of them. First of all, the stable category has a canonical structure of a triangulated category. And moreover, it is triangle equivalent to certain Verdier quotient of derived category of R, modulo the 6 subcategory KB project R. Here, Proje R means the category of finitely generated projective R modules, and KB Proje R is the bounded homotopy category over Proje R. So this shows a connection between derived category and stable category, and the right-hand side is nowadays called singularity category due to Orlov. And the last property I would mention here is the case when R is a hypersurface. In this case, the stable category can be described by very explicit calculation by matrix factorization. Yeah, so there are various ways to understand the stable category. So now, actually in this part one, I need a slightly more general setting. I need to start with abelian group G, and we assume R is a G-graded Gorenstein ring. Moreover, in this case, we denote by CMGR the category of G-graded Cohen-Macaulay R modules, and then its stable category is defined by completely similar way as before. And also then, this stable category also has a canonical structure of a triangulated category, and the property I mentioned before for ungraded case also still true under certain modifications. Okay. So now let's look at one simple example of Cohen-Macaulay representation. Yes, it is a very simple ring. R is quotient of a polynomial ring of one variables, model of principal ideal generated by Xn, and the degree of X is 1. So this is a Z-graded ring. In this case, R is actually self-injective in the sense that R is an injective module over itself. In particular, it is Gorenstein. And the self-injectivity implies that Cohen-Macaulay modules are precisely finitely generated modules. And in this special ring R, the classification of indecomposable module is very simple. It is given by quotient of Kx modulo the ideal Xi for I from 1 to n. And if we consider the category of graded R module, then all indecomposable objects are obtained by taking degree shift of these Xi. And it is quite easy to describe Hauslander-Leighton quiver of this category in this way. For n equal, for simplicity, I draw the case n equal 4. In this case, Hauslander-Leighton quiver of G-graded R module is given in this way. So in the bottom line, we have R. Next line, we have X3, X2, and X1. Yes. And by deleting R's in the bottom, we have the Hauslander-Leighton quiver of the stable category of graded R module. And now this picture we already saw before, namely this is what is called ZA3 and appeared as the Hauslander-Leighton quiver of derived category of type A3 quiver. And this is not just a coincidence of Hauslander-Leighton quiver. In fact, there is a triangle equivalence. Well, and slide doesn't work now. Should I wait? Yes, actually, we have a triangle equivalence between the stable category of Kx modulo X3 and the derived category of type A3. Maybe some of you don't know what is Hauslander-Leighton quiver. I just explain quickly. It has vertices consisting of isomorphism classes of indecomposable objects, and arrows in Hauslander-Leighton quiver shows certain special morphism called Hildebrand morphism. So by looking at the Hauslander-Leighton quiver, we can understand the structure of the category. Yeah, this is the reason people write Hauslander-Leighton quiver. Well, oh, yes, what is now stop?
How can you explain us this arrows in Icelander written quivers that you wrote there with this minus 2 and 1?
Yes, minus, yes, bracket shows the degree shift.
Ah, yes.
And yes, so because each xi is a quotient of kx modulo ideal xi, so there's a natural surjection from R to xn minus 1, xn minus 1 to xn minus 2, and so on. So they give us arrow in this, well, northwest direction. And arrows in southeast direction is a natural inclusion between them. Yeah. Yes, so yes, we are talking about Auslander, I think you are here. And actually, yes, we talk to two categories. One is the derived category of Kuiper and the stable category of KX modulo XN, and they are actually equivalent as triangulated category. So this was the last part we talked. So now I wanted to give a different example. Well, so yes, to explain it, let me recall classical theorem by Buchbeitz, Gloyer, Schreyer. This is, in a word, a commutative counterpart of Gabriel's theorem for Kuiper representation. So here, R is a commutative complete local Goldenstein K algebra. Then R is Cohen-Macaulay finite in the sense that there are only finitely many isomorphism classes of indecomposable object, Cohen-Macaulay R module, if and only if R is one of the simple singularity. So it is a hypersurface defined by one of these ADE polynomials. Okay. And now let's concentrate in the case dimension 2. And moreover, we consider Z-graded version of simple singularity, where grading is given by this table. In this case, there is again a triangle equivalence between the stable category of graded Cohen-Macaulay R module and the derived category of Kuiper Q. Here, Q is a Kuiper having same type as simple singularity. So this triangle equivalence, in a word, give a connection between two theorems, Gabriel's theorem for Kuiper representation and Buchbeitz, Gloyer, Schreyer theorem for Goldenstein ring. So now, yes, before we already observed two equivalences, both equivalences is an equivalence between stable category and derived category. Then natural question is, are there any other similar equivalence? And actually answer is yes, there are many, and we will see more example. And another question is how to construct such triangle equivalence? Then answer is to use tilting theory, which I will explain now. So tilting theory is a theory for triangulated categories. And the key notion was introduced by Ricard. We call an object U in T a tilting object if the following two conditions is satisfied. First one is there is no non-zero map from U to U shift by I for any non-zero I. Second condition is U is enough big to generate the category T as a six subcategory. And typical example is in the homotopy category of project lambda, there is a tilting object given by Stoke complex lambda. And actually, in some sense, the converse of this statement is true in the following sense. By using Keller's theory on differential graded category, one can prove the following. So now let's assume T is an algebraic triangulated category. For example, the stable category of Cohen-Macaulay module is algebraic. And assume U is a tilting object in T, then there is a triangle equivalence between T and the homotopy category of projective module over the endomorphism ring of U. In particular, if moreover global dimension of endomorphism ring is finite, then homotopy category coincides with derived category. Therefore, by combining this, we have a triangle equivalence between T and the derived category of lambda. So this shows that if we find out a tilting object in certain reasonable triangulated category, then can get such kind of triangle equivalence. So now we apply this proposition to some concrete case to have more example. And the first case is dimension zero. So we, here we consider certain R, which is a Z-graded finite dimensional self-injective algebra. In this case, we moreover assume that R doesn't have negative degrees, and moreover, the degree zero part have finite global dimension. Under these technical assumptions, one can show that the stable category of graded R module has a tilting object given by this formula. And here, this sign, this symbol means the following. If we write down x greater than or equal to zero, then this is a submodule of x given by this formula. Yeah, so this is a very simple construction of tilting object for rather general class of self-injective algebra. Applying this to this ring we discussed before, then we immediately recover the triangle equivalence we saw before. But more important application is a classical result due to Happel. So this is given for a finite dimensional K algebra lambda with a finite global dimension. In this case, we denote by T lambda the trivial extension algebra of lambda. This is as a vector space, a direct sum of lambda and K dual of lambda, and this is a multiplication given by this formula. So T lambda has an algebra structure, and moreover, it has natural Z grading given by this. Degree zero part is lambda, degree one part is d lambda, and other parts are zero. In this case, applying previous theorem, one can immediately get that the stable category of graded module over trivial extension is equivalent to the derived category of original algebra lambda. So this corollary is very important in representation theory of self-injective algebra. So now we discuss the case of dimension one. So here we consider commutative Gorenstein ring in dimension one. As before, we assume that R doesn't have negative degree, and moreover, degree zero part is a field. In addition, we assume R is reduced. Under this assumption, one can show that the stable category of graded Cohen-Macaulay R module has a tilting object. This is completely same formula as in the case of dimension zero. And there is also similar result for non-reduced case, but I will omit to save time. And the typical application of this theorem is a simple singularity in dimension one. Here, Z grading on R is given by this table. Yes. And in this case, we again have a triangle equivalence between stable category of graded Cohen-Macaulay R module and derived category of Dinkin-Cuiber Q. Here, Cuiber Q is defined by this list. So mostly Q has the same type as simple singularity, but there is some change. A odd case and D odd case are somehow interchanged. Anyway, so this is the example for dimension one. So thus, in dimension zero and one, we know there are rather general existence theorem of tilting object. Then it is natural to ask, how about higher dimension? Actually, higher dimensional case, tilting object exists only for nice cases. And below, we explain two nice cases. One is called Geiger-Lenzing complete intersection, and the other is example come from pre-projective algebra. So I start with Geiger-Lenzing intersection, complete intersection case. So it is defined, so we need to start with a polynomial algebra of a field K with d plus one variable. And we need to choose some linear forms L1 to Ln from C, And also, we need to choose integers p1 to pn, which are at least 2. And using these data, we define a ring R by this formula. Yeah. So R is a quotient of a polynomial ring over C with variable x1 to xn, modulo the ideal generated by xi pi minus li. So this is a commutative ring. On the other hand, we also need an abelian group which gives grading on R. It is denoted as L and defined as a quotient of free abelian group generated by C and x1 to xn, and take quotient by subgroup generated by pi xi minus c. Then somehow this relation, as this relation explains, R has natural L grading given by this. So degree of original variable Tj is this element C, and degree of new variable x1 to xn is small x1 to xn. And it is almost immediate from definition that this abelian group L is an abelian group of rank 1, and moreover, R is a complete intersection ring in dimension d plus 1. Moreover, R has an invariant omega given by this formula. This is a special element in grading group L. So an invariant means that the d plus 1 extension from K2, R shift by omega is isomorphic to K as graded module. So this omega play important role in the theory of Geiger-Lenzing complete intersection. And now definition comes. We call the pair RL a Geiger-Lenzing complete intersection if any choice of at most d plus element from linear form L1 to Ln are linearly independent. Yeah. So L1 to Ln are in general position in this sense. For example, under this assumption, if n is at most d plus 1, then R is a polynomial algebra. And the next case, if n equals d plus 2, then R becomes a hypersurface and it is isomorphic to the ring of this form. And now we look at the classical case, d equal 1, and this case was studied by Geiger and Lenzing in 87 in the context of weighted projective line. And in this case, R can be written in this form, and one important class of weighted projective line is called domestic. It is defined by this numerical inequality. Actually, in this case, one can consider the Veronese subring of R corresponding to the element omega. And actually, this subring is a simple singularity in dimension 2. Moreover, the Cohen-Macaulay representation of R coincides with that of Veronese subring. Here, I show you the table. So this shows all possible cases of domestic type, and this shows the type of simple singularity of the Veronese subring. So this shows how Geiger-Lenzing complete intersection are related to our first example of simple singularity. So now about existence or equivalence with derived category, when one can state main theorem. So for any Geiger-Lenzing complete intersection, there is a triangle equivalence between the stable category of R and the derived category of some algebra ACM. Here, ACM, to define ACM, we need a certain partial order in grading group L defined by this. And ACM is defined as a matrix algebra of this form. Yeah. So rows and columns of matrix is parameterized by elements in L between 0 and this special element in L. And the degree xy entry is rx minus y. This is a K algebra by usual product in R and usual matrix multiplication. I just show you the simplest example of ACM. So for hypersurface case n equal to d plus 2, ACM is just a tensor product of type A quiver. And the next simple case, n equal to d plus 3 and all pi's are 2, then ACM is given by this quiver and there are two relations in this quiver. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, there are more examples, but I need to go to the part 2. Yes, there are not so much time remaining. So in part 1, we discuss connection between derived category of graded Cohen-Macaulay module. In part 2, I will discuss cluster category and ungraded Cohen-Macaulay modules. And the cluster category were introduced in categorification of cluster algebra by Fomi and Zerubinsky. And the cluster category was first introduced by Buan, Marsh, Reinek, Wright, and Todorov for quiver case, and Amion and Guo based on Keller's work for more general lambda. And in the construction, the notion of orbit category is very important, so let me define quickly. So now let T be an additive category and F be an automorphism of T. In this case, the orbit category T over F have the same object as original T, and the morphism group in T over F from X to Y is given by the direct sum of morphism group in T from X to FIY. And the composition of morphism can be defined naturally. Yeah, I will not write a formula. Now, I explain why orbit category appear naturally in our context. For this, let's recall our motivating first simple triangle equivalence. In this case, the Auslander right-hand quiver of right left-hand side is given by this. Here, red arrow shows that how degree shift functor acts on the category. Yeah. So degree shift by one, move everything one step to the right. And similarly, the Auslander right-hand quiver of right-hand side is given by this, and this category have important automorphism called tau, Auslander right-hand translation, which move everything one step to the left. Then just comparing these two diagrams, we know that degree shift functor is precisely the inverse of Auslander right-hand translation. Therefore, yes, use from this equivalence, taking orbit category, we still have equivalence of additive category. And now let's look at the right-hand side. So we consider Z-graded module, but we take orbit category by degree shift by one. Then in this case, the result is just the stable category of ungraded module over this ring. Yes. Yeah, this case every module is gradable. This is not true in general, but this case we have such equality. And the right-hand side is the definition of cluster category. So to explain right-hand side more explicitly, I need to explain cell functor. So here, let T be a K-linear homofinite triangulated category. And we call an automorphism S of T a cell functor if there is a bifunctorial isomorphism of this form. So right-hand side is morphism space from X to Y, and left-hand side is K-dual of morphism space from Y to SX. Yeah. And classical result by Happel shows that if triangulated category have a cell functor, then Auslander right-hand theory work in that triangulated category. And the typical example of cell functor is given by smooth projective variety in dimension D. In this case, the derived category of coherent sieve have a cell functor given by tensoring with canonical sieve and shift by D. Another famous example due to Happel is appear in for finite dimensional algebra with finite global dimension. In this case, the bounded derived category has a cell functor written as nu, which is the derived functor of tensor product with d lambda. Yeah, this functor is called Nakayama functor. And the last well-known example is due to Auslander. It is for Gorenstein isolated singularity in dimension d plus 1. In this case, the stable category of Cohen-Macaulay module is D Calabi-Yau in the sense that shift by D gives a cell functor. Yeah. So those three are very well-known examples of cell functor. Now we can explain cluster category. So let lambda be finite dimensional algebra with global dimension at most D. Then we denote by nu d the composition of cell functor nu and shift by minus d. This functor actually plays a very important role. The special case nu 1 is usually written as tau and called Auslander Rytan translation. And here we denote by C O D lambda the orbit category of derived category modulo the action of nu d. Unfortunately, this is an additive category, but it does not have a structure of triangulated category in general. But the theorem due to Amio Guo-Keller shows that there is a triangulated category CD lambda called D cluster category, which contains the orbit category as a full subcategory, and moreover, natural functor from derived category to cluster category is a triangle functor. So cluster category is constructed by using DG enhancement of derived category, and one important property of cluster category is that if it is homofinite, then it is Calabi-Yau, D Calabi-Yau. Yes. So this is very similar. So therefore, we can expect it has a similar property to the stable category of Cohen-Macaulay module over Gorenstein ring. And another important property of cluster category is that they have a nice object called cluster tilting. Actually, this class of object appeared in higher dimensional Auslander Rytan theory, and let me define quickly it. So it appears for triangulated category or exact category. In this case, we call an object M in T a D cluster tilting object if the following three conditions for object X in T are equivalent. First condition is X is a direct summons of direct sums of copies of M. Second condition is there is no map from M to X shift by I for each I between 1 to D minus 1. And the third condition is dual to the second one. And for example, the case D equal 1 appears for Cohen-Macaulay finite ring. If R is Cohen-Macaulay finite, then the category CMR has a natural one cluster tilting object given by direct sum of all indecomposable Cohen-Macaulay modules up to isomorphism. And in the setting of cluster category, we have the following Amio Guo result. If cluster category is homofinite, then the object lambda in cluster category gives a D cluster tilting object. So now let's recall a triangle equivalence between this our standard example. Then now we discuss question, are there other similar equivalents? And the answer is yes, there are many. And now we will see the example given by preprojective algebra. So preprojective algebra is defined for finite dimensional algebra with global dimension at most D. In this case, we denote by E the D's extension group from K dual of lambda to lambda. It has a natural lambda bimodule structure. And in this setting, we consider the tensor algebra of lambda bimodule E. And we denote it as pi, or more explicitly, pi d plus 1 lambda. And we call this is a graded algebra, and we call it the d plus 1 preprojective algebra. So this, of course, has a Z grading whose degree I part is tensor product of I copies of E. By definition, degree zero part of pi is original algebra lambda, and degree I part have interpretation as zero cohomology of the complex nu d minus I lambda. And this isomorphism, this identification tells us that pi has a meaning as the endomorphism algebra of lambda in the D cluster category. Now let's look at the classical case D equal 1. This case, pi have a much simpler description. So in this case, we need to start with finite dimensional hereditary K algebra. Hereditary means global dimension is at most 1. This is equivalent to that lambda is the path algebra of certain quiver Q up to Morita equivalence. And now we consider the double Q bar of Q. It is obtained by adding inverse arrow to Q for each arrow in Q. For example, if Q is this type AN quiver, then its double is this. And actually, then preprojective algebra of path algebra KQ has this very explicit description as quotient of path algebra of Q bar modulo the ideal generated by these commutators. And one important point of preprojective algebra is that they enjoy nice homological properties under the following de-hereditary condition. Yeah, this is a generalization of hereditary property, but the definition is a bit different. So now for each integer I, we consider the complex nu d I lambda. Then this is concentrated in degree dz. This is the definition of de-hereditary. De-hereditary algebra have the following dichotomy theorem. We assume lambda is ring indecomposable. Then, lambda is de-hereditary if and only if one of the following conditions holds. First condition is that there is a D-cluster tilting object in module category of lambda. This case, we call lambda D-representation finite. The second case is that for each integer I, nu d minus I lambda, this is a complex, but it is concentrated in degree zero. In this case, we call lambda d representation infinite. These names are motivated by the following immediate observation. In the classical case d equal 1, finite dimensional k algebra lambda is one representation finite if and only if lambda is path algebra of Dynkin quiver, so this is representation finite. And lambda is one representation infinite if and only if lambda is path algebra of non-Dynkin quiver. So it is representation infinite in usual sense. So now let's explain result for D representation finite algebra. I denote by pi the preprojective algebra. Then in this case, pi is actually a finite dimensional and moreover self-injective algebra. Therefore, a stable category have a structure of triangulated category, and moreover, the stable category of Z-graded pi module is equivalent to the derived category of endomorphism ring of pi. And if we consider the stable category of ungraded pi module, then it is equivalent to D plus 1 cluster category of the same ring. In particular, the stable category is D plus 1 Calabi-Yau triangulated category, and moreover, has a D plus 1 cluster tilting object. These properties are known in classical case D equal 1 before. I just show you some example of D representation finite algebra parameterized by two integer D and I. It is defined inductively by this formula. But I show some quiver. Lambda 1,4 is just a pass algebra of type A4, and its preprojective algebra is given by the double. Then next lambda 2,4 is given by this triangle, then its preprojective algebra is given by this quiver. Then next lambda 3,4 is given by this tetrahedral, and its preprojective algebra is given by this quiver, and the next one is given by this fourth simplex, and the preprojective algebra is obtained by this. Anyway, in each step, we have a triangle equivalence between stable category of preprojective algebra and cluster category of same kind of algebra with different numbers. In the rest of my talk, I will talk about D representation infinite algebra. Yes, I assume I can talk a bit more. Yes, because... 2 minutes, okay. So now setting is lambda is D representation infinite algebra, and pi is, we assume pi is Noetherian. And we assume there is a nice idempotent E of lambda satisfying these two conditions. Under this condition, we define R as the subalgebra E pi E of pi, and let lambda prime be the quotient of lambda modulo the ideal E generated by E. In this setting, R is a Gorenstein ring, and lambda prime is a finite dimensional algebra with global dimension at most D. And in this case, the stable category of graded Cohen-Macaulay module has a tilting object given by pi e, and moreover, it is a triangle equivalent to the derived category of lambda prime. And similarly, under stable category of ungraded Cohen-Macaulay module have corresponding properties. So this is the main result for D representation infinite case. And I just show you one simple case, D equal 1. So Q is extended Dynkin quiver, and E is extended vertex, and pi and R is defined as before. Then it is well known by Guy Lenting that R is a simple singularity in dimension 2, and also known by Auslander that CMR has a one cluster tilting object. And by our result, for Dynkin quiver Q prime obtained from Q by removing E, we have these triangle equivalences. And, to explain, actually there are more examples obtained by using bisection between D representation infinite algebra and certain algebra called Calabi-Yau algebra of Gorenstein or A invariant minus one, but I skip definition. And using this, we can find out more examples for toric singularity in dimension 3 and also quotient singularity. So now my time finished. So thank you very much.
Are there any questions? Okay, so let's thank again Osamu for this nice talk and all the speakers this afternoon.